every venue is so different, and every venue kind of has a stigma attached to it, or not. When I play a certain place, it's not necessarily what I'm bringing to the venue, but what the audience is filling it with, and also the echo of everything that's happened in that particular venue before. So it's really, really fun to try different places. The combination of the venue and the audience always directs our shows, because they're improvised. Like if we're playing in like a crazy like shit cement box where people have been like freaking out and, you know, moshing or for years, like we always tend to have that electricity. Or if you're playing in like a soft cedar and it's very demure, we end up kind of almost falling into the record groove of the history of the place a little bit. And then of course bringing our own juice, which is good. Thing about growing up in Nunavut is I'm pretty grounded. Like I'm not even afraid to make that statement that I'm grounded, and I'm lucky because I spend half my time in the air, so happy to have some roots on the ground. I've been doing this for a long time. I think society is just, it's such an interesting time in our culture and Canadian culture. Like Indigenous people are having a voice, and you know, when I was growing up it was a little bit more of the shunning of our own culture. I'm very, very interested in pre-Christian Inuit life, and I'm very interested in the amalgamation of culture. Like every country we go to, I inquire on the political system, and also take serious note of the social climate resulting from each political system, and how people act and react to certain situations, and how socialization is the spearhead of everything. Like people will do anything if everyone else is doing it. And people will be civil if everyone else is being civil. And people will hate a certain thing if everybody's hating a certain... Like, it's so strange how that all works in every culture. I try to look at every country and their system and go, okay, what's working best here? And then I take that hope, and this may sound really naive, but I take that hope and go, maybe Canada can have this. You know, maybe our country can, you know, rise above this like broken, crazy history, and you know, maybe, just maybe, I could have something to do with a shift in the statistics that, you know, my people live under. Well, people live under, they're not mine, you know. People call me an activist, but I don't consider myself an activist. I consider myself somebody that is alive and has been living this life, hoping to make life better for people I see hurting.
Thank you.
wasn't until later in life that I started learning throat singing in my mid-20s. And it was so there in my bones already, just existing. So it just happened really organically. It's a very, very old tradition that I've kind of taken on my own. And it's actually pissed a lot of people off, because there's a lot of people that are really upset that I don't do it traditionally. But I kind of feel like I do. When I was really young, I would get so angry. Kids would want to practice hunting, right, and practice killing things. And I would never like seeing anyone kill anything that they weren't going to eat. Like, I've never found joy in that. I just never understood. I just always thought it was so hypocritical. Like, at home in the 80s, like, even when we were really young, I was so unpopular because I was talking about gay rights, and people really fucking hated that at the time. And, you know, when I'm at home and people are bashing white people or saying white people this, white people that, I was never cool with the generalization. And also down here, like, the people I grew up with at home are like the smartest, kindest, most giving, awesome people I've ever met. And to hear them put down and disparaged by society, that's when I started getting loud, and when I started fighting something that wasn't an individual. Like, how I could, like, peck at the government, you know? Like.
Woo!
harnessing social media, it's such a crazy thing, like, you know, making a tweet and it becomes a headline.
And the hilariousness of having people giving shit for not being traditional over the internet.
Christianity has been a big sickness put on our people, I think. And you can't tell me people weren't getting freaky in the igloo in the middle of, you know, the winter. It feels really like super ancestral for me. And I don't mind, you know, being a heretic or perverting it a bit, because that's who I am and how I grew up.
only hope that'll make nobody else know.